Now, why am I here today? I'm here to share four important turning points in my life. And all these four turning points have one common thread, and that is of humiliation. How humiliation acted as motivation in all my life. Now, as a child, I was a strange kid, always called to the principal's office, really bad at academics, hated math, and that is why I am standing here pursuing law as a lawyer today. And notorious, very always known for the wrong reasons. But there was one day in 9th standard when we had the open day, and the open day was the most dreaded day of my life. I wanted that day to never come. And that is the day my mother walks in, like every year, and this time something different happens. My professor, my class teacher, decides to insult me and my mother publicly in front of the entire classroom, in front of the entire parents group and everybody. And that day something happened. My mother, who is a single mother who has raised us, who is very strong, who started her own business, she starts crying. I've never seen my mother cry. And that day I decide and I make a vow to myself that this humiliation and this crying that my mother did today, she will never do for her entire life because of me. She will never cry because of me for her entire life. And that is the day I changed. I changed, I became a sincere student. I scored well in my 10th. I came in the top 10 in the school. The same followed in commerce. I was the best student. I was elected the general secretary. And life from then to now has always been on a high just because of that one humiliation that my mom faced that day. In college, life was really good. I could participate in everything. And I started my consulting and coaching business side by side to support my mother. And of course, because I was so responsible as well. Now, during this coaching business doing very well, and we were making some commercial success, a lot of friends advised me that, Kunal, now you're earning well. Please start and incorporate a company. Structure yourself. It will help you from the tax reasons, and it also help you to scale. And I said, all right. When I went to professionals, when I went to chartered accountants, when I went to lawyers, again, this is the second turning point, friends, where humiliation did not leave me. I am this person who's bright, who started this coaching business. We are doing more than 20 lakhs a year. And these professionals, when I went to their office, treated me with a lot of humiliation, treated me as a child. Of course, I was 18 that time. But they actually marked an X on documents. They put these stickers and they said, you sign here. As if I'm some illiterate person. They told me, give me 8,000 rupees, give me 10,000 rupees and we'll take care of it. They didn't try to understand my business. They didn't try to understand my story, nothing. Just like that, all my hard work, all my academic success, everything gone down to that one cross on the paper. That day I felt a lot of people like me, a lot of students like me want to be entrepreneurs, want to start their own business, but they are facing these kind of professionals. I said, this is not going to happen. I will not let any other student face what I have faced today. And that day I decided. So by the way, I was very good at studies and everything after that humiliation incident. But I had no answer to the why. You know that existential question that we all have, what is my purpose? That day at the CA's office, I found my purpose. And the purpose was to help entrepreneurs start and to help entrepreneurs scale. Now, I finished all the courses that are required to help people scale. I finished my CA, my CS, my law, everything at 19. So that I could help people start their own businesses successfully. Now, coming to the main, I think the fourth most important turning point of my life is my introduction to intellectual property. So I was sitting there in the office with my senior where a 13-year-old client walked in, 13-year-old. And this client was an author. The kind of discussions that were happening really intrigued me and really excited me as to what was following. The sir then explained that this girl, I can't name her due to confidentiality, but this girl is making an income of 19 lakh rupees every year, and her parents have quit their jobs to become ambassadors for her. Now this was shocking for me. How can a 13-year-old girl make 20 lakhs a year? And stories kept following. Stories of how to, once something is created, it can be milked for the entire lifetime. My sir told me about the movie Sholay. Said, Mr. Sippy is earning around 5 crores from Sholay even today. He spoke about the popular sitcom Friends, where Ross and Chandler are still making $20 million because of the reruns. He gave me numerous examples, and he also gave me examples of all the recent companies. For example, if I ask you, which are the most successful five companies today, the answers would be Uber, Airbnb, Oyo, or what, Ola, all these companies. Please note, none of these companies have any assets. It's all based on the intellectual property, a simple algorithm, a source code. Flipkart recently got $1 billion. One of the founders got valued at $16 billion. On the basis of what? Flipkart doesn't own any inventory. It is based on one intellectual property, the website, the source code. Now, this epiphany, this enlightenment, I had to apply. I got this restlessness in myself that if all these people are doing it, why can't I? And I did a smart thing. When I decided to start my firm, I named my firm as White Collar Legal. And I fell in love with the name, as you fall in love with all your creations. I spent a great deal of money, more than a lakh, on registering this name internationally. A lot of people told me, Kunal, you're stupid. At the start of your career, you spend 1 lakh on a name that doesn't even have a name, doesn't even have goodwill or reputation. Why are you doing this? And I knew why I was doing it. You won't believe, the year after I got my international trademark registration done for White Collar Legal, another firm came up in UK with the name of White Collar Legal. I said, let's not send him a notice right away. Let's wait. Let's wait so that he builds a practice. Let's wait till he does some marketing. Let's wait till he does some business. And 1 year after he registered the name himself, I sent him a notice and I said, boss, I own the name, please stop. And the response was very natural. The response was, he said, Kunal, you're a lawyer like me. I'm using this name. I've done a business around this name. I have clients now. I can't change the name. Can we work something out? And at that point, I said, yes, we can work something out. What do you think? And I said, Philip, please pay me 10% of what billing you do. And Philip said, Kunal, 10%, you're killing me. Can you reduce it a bit? And we settled at 6%. Now today when I stand before you, we are so happy to share that we get 6% billing of a UK-based firm every month. And please note, they bill in pounds. Something that is created once is going to help me 60 years after my death, because that is the term of the registration. Fourth turning point. To create something that will outlast you, that will outlive you. If I had to give you a basic reason of why people like this do it or why I did it, the simple answer is everybody. For example, you must be knowing people who keep going abroad, right? The rich uncles, especially in your family, they keep taking business trips. And you always feel these business trips are for pleasure, right? They keep posting it on Instagram or Facebook check-ins. But trust me, these business trips are pure business. To give you an example, a client of ours had visited a fellow Asian country and experienced a concept of an underground restaurant there. He saw that restaurant, he loved it, he paid 30,000 per person to dine there, came back to India and asked us, Kunal, is somebody doing this in India? We did a search and we found out nobody was doing it. Immediately we registered that idea in his name. And within 3 years, he sold that underground restaurant concept to a prominent builder and who is into multiple things. You know, the cost of registering that idea was 8,000 rupees. And the cost of which he sold it to the builder is 55 crores. Is this good return? It's better than Bitcoin, if you agree. Now, when I went to the client and I said, boss, you made a lottery. He said, Kunal, that was one of the 18 concepts I have in my pocket. At that point, I said, shit, if a local businessman has 18 concepts in his pocket, what do you think Mr. Azim Premji or Mr. Mukesh Ambani must be having? They must have blocked all the ideas that there are out there. Which brought me to a question that all of us have ideas at some point in our life. Every person who has taken a shower in this room, and I hope all of them have, has an idea. But the world does not, what do you say, reward a person with an idea. The world rewards a person who expresses the idea, who registers the idea, and who monetizes the idea. If you don't take the first step of expressing it, somebody else will register that idea. And that must have happened. When the cycle sharing system came, a lot of people came to me and said, Kunal, I had got that idea in 2008. I said, what? So what? Everybody gets an idea. Ideas are nobody's monopoly. Person who moves first wins the race. And therefore, I'll leave you with two very strong maxims that we use in our legal field. Number one is the person who files first is the inventor and not the person who invents first. Please understand the gravity of the statement. If you file first, you're the inventor, not if you invent first. And number two, if you snooze, you lose. If you have something good, move fast. I leave you with that. And therefore, this work of helping people take their idea to impact has taken me in a great deal. Once I've started this work, more than 24 of my clients have got funded. Some of them have got funding more than $2 million. And that is why I'm standing before you. Because when you help people to grow, you also grow along with them. Therefore, the TED Talk happened. The Ministry of Youth Affairs invited me to become their ambassador. I wanted to learn at certain colleges like the Tata Institute of Social Sciences. They called me as faculty. I wanted to go to IIM Calcutta. They called me as faculty. So life is really good when you start helping people. Now my job to all of you is, next time you have an idea, please express it. When I say express it, I mean put it on paper. If it's an app, create a demo version, register it in your name. And if you don't want to work on it, it is fine. Sell it to a person who wants to work on it. The goal is not to live forever. It is to create something that will. Thank you so much.
Tell us what you think about this video and don't forget to like, share and subscribe.